Yeah, you get the picture. That scene played out in New York City yesterday, just 24 hours after a cop was shot and killed by a suspect here, the fourth NYPD officer to die this year. Just the latest in a series of controversial protests by the Black Lives Matter movement over the last year.
If you are not black, please move out of the center of the space.
Pigs in a blanket! Fried white bacon! Pigs in a blanket! Fried white bacon! Pigs in a blanket! Fried white bacon!
The group says it wants people to pay attention to injustice, but the message often sounds more like, don't trust the police. So now critics are questioning why both political parties have endorsed the idea of presidential town halls. These town hall meetings, you know, that we see, hosted by the Black Lives Matter group. Lisa Durden is a political commentator. Mark Furman is a former LAPD homicide detective and a Fox News contributor. Great to see you both. So, Mark, what does it tell you that not just the Democrats, but the Republicans have now agreed to participate in a town hall meeting hosted by the Black Lives Matter movement?
Well, it's an election year. You have all these candidates in both parties. They're all politically petrified of any issue to do with race. They want the black vote, so they're appeasing and going along with the program. And it's really shameful, and I think it's really cowardly. This is a radical, subversive group that has claimed, whether they participate or incite the death of police officers, they certainly celebrate it. It's disgusting. Anybody that actually supports or allows this and is a politician shouldn't be elected to office.
Lisa, do you have any idea, like, who would run? Who they wanted a presidential debate, and the GOP and the Dems said no to that. So they're going to, who's going to host it? Who's going to ask the questions? The one chanting pigs in a blanket, fry them like bacon, does he get a say?
Well, I don't think individuals who are negative and subversive are going to get a say. The Black Lives Matter Network will be hosting this event, and the DNC and the RNC knew very well that they better had given them the opportunity to host this presidential town hall meeting because the world is watching. America can't have this attitude that they are diverse and they welcome everyone, but then they snub the Black Lives Matter Network. Mm-hmm. Now, this tape you showed, I mean, there are going to always be individuals who are going to do negative things. No rebellion is planned to include people getting murdered and people having fighting. But we have to have rebellion to break the bones of individuals.
That's a point we hear a lot, that those individuals we just saw don't represent this movement.
Correct.
Oh. Megan, it's interesting is we keep hearing this from the Black Lives Matter supporters, but we don't see any leaders from Black Lives Matter to stand up and say, we don't support the death of police officers. We don't want the death of police officers. We support the government, but they don't. They're a radical revolutionary group, much like the Black Panthers. Actually, their ideals are right from 1966, from Huey Newton. It's exactly the same thing, anti-government, defend against any kind of oppression of the black people, even if they're criminals, even if they commit capital crimes, even if they commit homicides. They're right, the police are wrong.
Lisa, is there anything you could hear from these GOPers at this town hall that would convince you to vote Republican?
Not at all. Nothing. But I have to correct Mr. Furman. There was somebody very huge that stood up against it, and that was our president, Barack Obama. In Ferguson, when some of the miscreants were looting and burning people's properties, he stood up at a press conference and said he does not believe in non-peaceful protests, and he told individuals not to do those things. But you can't look at one small population and blame the entire movement.
All right. Well, it'll be interesting to watch.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Great to see you both.
But that's what I'm talking about.
Great to see you both. And I love when they do the split screen, like, goodbye, goodbye, it's over. Also tonight.